from the Music Village Auditorium in Nashville, Tennessee, America salutes a gospel music legend in a tribute to Duddy Rambo with special guests Ricky Van Shelton, Ricky Skaggs and Sharon White, Pat Boone, Marty Rabun, Connie Smith, GDC Riley, Lulu Roman, Ben Kinslow, Barbara Fairchild, Cindy Morgan, Vicky Winans, Dino and Cheryl Kartsanakis, Donnie and Reba Rambo McGuire, The Hemp Hills, The Music City Mass Choir, Mylon LeFevre, Jeff Benholm, Vern Jackson, Mike Kirky, Terry McMillan, Janet Pascal, Bill and Renee Morris, Andy Hemp Hill, Bill Traylor, Destiny and Israel McGuire, and Dion McGuire. And now, please welcome Dino! Welcome, President and Founders of the Trinity Broadcasting Network, Paul and Jan
What a night, what a night we are going to have. I think all of the city of Nashville is here. How many call Nashville home here in this great area of the world? We have thought about this night and gotten excited about this night and planned this night, and Jan's been doing lots of hard work, and here we are.
Yes, and wonderful. I can't think of anyone in the whole wide world that all of these people would come out, and all of these that are backstage, and there are many to honor more than our precious Dottie Rambo. And we're here just to tell her, Dottie, we love you. That's it. Okay.
Where is Dottie, by the way? She's on the way. All right. Oh, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. For the Lord Most High is over all the earth. He shall subdue the people under us and the nations under our feet. He shall choose our inheritance for us, the excellency of Jacob, whom he loved. God is gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of the trumpet. Sing praises to God. Sing praises. Sing praises unto our King. Sing praises. Boy, we're going to do that tonight, aren't we? For God is the King of all the earth. Sing ye praises with understanding. God reigneth over the heathen. God sitteth upon his throne of his holiness. The princes of the people are gathered together, even the people of the God of Abraham. For the power of the earth belongeth to God. He is greatly exalted. Let's give praise and glory and honor to him tonight, as we also honor a wonderful little handmaiden of the Lord who has blessed us again and again and again and again. How many have been lifted at one time or another with Behold the Lamb, or Too Much to Gain to Lose, or I Will Glory in the Cross, and on and on and on. 2,000 plus songs that have blessed us. And now we gather tonight to bless our little angel, Dottie Rambo, whom we love very, very much. Did you know the Honorable Phil Bredesen has declared this Dottie Rambo Day in Nashville? Whereas legendary gospel singer and songwriter Dottie Rambo has been a resident of Nashville, Tennessee for most of her adult life, and whereas she has a distinguished career as a songwriter with over 2,200 songs to her credit, including such classics as Behold the Lamb, We Shall Behold Him, If That Isn't Love, Remind Me, Dear Lord, and countless others. And whereas, I won't read all the whereases. Now, therefore, I, Philip Bredesen, Mayor of Metropolitan Nashville, Davidson County, do hereby proclaim Thursday, February 24th, 1994, as Dottie Rambo Day in Nashville. Thank you, Mayor Bredesen, for that kind honor. We have another distinguished individual who has sent greetings today from a place called the White House. Dear Mrs. Rambo, I want to extend my congratulations as you are honored with the Christian Country Music Association Songwriter of the Century Award. The distinguished array of musicians assembled for this special ceremony tell us all that what a respected and extraordinary influence you have had in the areas of gospel and country music. Through your songs, you've promoted the concepts of charity, faith, and goodwill. Your music has brought joy and inspiration to many lives around the world, and I am confident it will continue to have an impact for many years to come. With my very best wishes, sincerely, Bill Clinton, President of the United States. And here she is, our sweetheart of the evening, Dottie Rambo.
Thank you.
I think you all know we love you very much, and there's too much to gain to lose. Give us a little blessing tonight as we get underway.
Well, God has truly given me a blessing. I have to tell you one tragedy and then tell you the good news about it. Got my toe hung in the carpet.
Yeah, we know.
Fell over and broke my dumb hip. Yes, it did. And I broke my little toe beside it. And then they put a big old pin, looks like a curling iron, in my hip. The devil said, I got you this time.
Oh, no.
Today is the first time I've been off of the crutches. And I got on the high heels, so I said, watch out, devil!
And defeat is one word I never use.
You know what? Paul, I sang that song all the time.
Yeah.
Defeat is one word I don't use. We've come too far, folks.
Amen.
We've come a long way. And I was telling friends in the limbo a while ago, I said, the Lord is soon coming.
Yes.
Do you know how soon it is, folks? The Lord's coming. And tonight, I thank you for being here. Such a sweet thing that TBN, Paul and Jan would do for me and for you. And I have a hard time accepting gifts and honors and awards. I always have had. I guess that's why God's let me have them, because I have a hard time saying
you
thank
you. You don't covet them.
No, I don't. I really don't. I run from them sometimes. But I've kind of cried some today, thinking back to the good times and thinking about TBN, what they've done for me and my family. And some of the songs that I have written have come from the heart of these two people. I've seen the pain that they have walked through and the valleys that you will never know about. So the world could see Jesus.
Yes.
On Christian television.
Thank you, Lord.
And I thank God, Paul, for all the thousands of miles across this world are looking right at us right now. Is my lipstick on straight?
Yeah. You look wonderful.
I thank all of you. I appreciate hearing from the president. I've got the hand of another great president right here, Paul Crouch. Isn't he great? Right here's the first lady. Isn't she pretty? I love you, darling. Just want to say thank you. I love you. It is such an honor. And this will be something for my grandbabies to look back on. Of course, I'll probably outlive them, you know.
I guess, Dottie, I want you to look around. You haven't seen this. But a special angel named Janie Garrison painted. And look at these angels. There's four of those, Dottie. We're in the angel room. And those of you that know the story, when Dottie moved into her gorgeous home there in Atlanta, she walked into a room and there were literal angels there waiting for her to get there to begin writing songs. And look at these back here, Dottie. They're absolutely incredible. Janie, you outdid yourself. And you know what they are going to be? They're going to be the set for Dottie's new TV show, Dottie and the Angel Room. From right here.
All right, I'm getting the high sign. We got to move. Dottie Angel, you have sung to us and blessed us again and again and again through the years. Tonight, we're going to sing to you. Let's tell Dottie Rambo we really do love her. Give her a big old hometown, we love you, applause, as Ricky Van Shelton comes to bless you tonight.
Hard to count the tears that have fallen. It would seem like an ocean. Yeah, I guess if my heart was just a big old wonder that you could just look right through. Oh, the pain and the scars you would see. 'cause the grave seems so final and cold. But we'll meet again where death has no victory, in a land where we'll never grow. And I've never met one man with no sorrow. I've never looked into someone's eyes with no pain. But I know a land where grief is a stranger, and songs of joy are the only songs we'll sing. Beautiful song, beautiful song, buddy. Beautiful song, beautiful song. You know, we're here, and I'm glad to be part of this. I'm glad that you asked me to be part of it. I really, really am. And I hope that everybody here and everybody across this land is blessed tonight by what you see and by what you hear. And since it is a tribute to Dottie Rambo, y'all bear with me. I got to do something. I saw you do this, and we have to humble ourselves sometime, right? Okay, hold on a minute. Who ain't got a hold of my sock? You sing with your shoes off, I thought I'd just do it too. Like I said, you gotta humble yourself sometimes. I feel the touch of hands so kind and tender. They're leading me in paths It's the last mile you must trot. I'll fall asleep and wake with God in heaven.
Thank you, brother. I'd join you, but I didn't bring my socks tonight. What a great night we're having as we pay tribute and honor. The scripture's clear. We should render honor to whom honor is due. And we joyfully do that tonight from Nashville, Tennessee. For you late tuners inners, this is Dottie Rambo night. And we're having a great time, and we've got all kinds of greetings and communications. Jan, honey, one from one of Dottie's girlfriends.
Yes. Barbara Mandrell sent a very special word to Dottie. Sweet. Says, "Dear Dottie, there's a very special place in my heart for you. I cherish your music and your friendship. I wish I could have been with you tonight to share in the celebration. I am sure it will be a wonderful night to remember. Your girlfriend, Barbara Mandrell."
Welcome Dino and Cheryl Kartsanakis as they come to pay special tribute to Dottie Rambo.
Thank you. Dottie, we love you. This is your day. And this is the only songwriter that I can sit at the piano and play, and people know the words when I play the music. And that's very important to me and to the ministry that I have. Dottie, we love you. Cheryl and I have grown to love your music. Every time when I played Behold the Lamb, where were you, Dottie? You weren't here when I played it. You were in the back there listening, I know. But I played it from the bottom of my heart. And the Spirit of God in that song, even when I was rehearsing, right, honey?
Yes, there's always an anointing on Dottie's music.
Yes.
She's so anointed herself, and God has. You are just such a treasure. The Lord has just poured His blessing through your treasure chest. I think you are, and He's just poured His blessings through you over and over again. And you know, can I tell how this started? Because I got the scoop backstage on a couple of things that you might not know. Maybe you do. But when Dottie got saved, she was a little 12-year-old girl. And her father asked her to leave home because he didn't like her being a Christian. Now, if I'm telling this wrong, honey, you change it. I know you will. So, anyway, and when you had to leave home, you went into churches. Dottie took a guitar and started going on a bus to churches around the country in 12 years old in Alabama and Tennessee and wherever else. And I can't see you now, so I'm not sure that this is all. I want to see that smile over there. But I know that you got married at 16, and then something wonderful happened. This is her little Cinderella story. Something wonderful happened. She was playing the guitar and singing, and a wonderful family heard her. Rusty and Vestal Goodman heard her songs and were so impressed and so thrilled, Dino, that they sent them, took them. Personally, it took you, I think, to the governor. No? I see the head shaking, But
to the mansion. Governor's mansion.
Sent them to the governor's mansion, and the governor had you brought there. Is that correct? And from then on, it's just been a whirlwind of wonderful blessing and music that we've all been tremendously impressed in our lives and our spirits by. And we cannot thank God enough for you, my dear. You are just so wonderful and precious. And thank you so much for allowing him to pour his blessing out to us through your life. And Dino,
what's the song they sing?
You know, the song is the very first one that Dottie ever wrote.
Oh, really? Okay.
What is that song, Dottie? There is nothing that my God can't do. That sounds appropriate for Dottie. For Dottie, and Joel and Labriska Hemphill are going to sing it for
and
me.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Hemphills, give a big hand, would you please?
There's nothing, no, nothing that my God can't do. He measured the sea in the span of his hand. Mountains were placed at his command. At the sound of his voice, the sun came through. And there's nothing, no, nothing that my God
hung them on high. The moon spread its light all across God's big sky. And this same mighty God can take a heart of stone, wash it and cleanse it and make it His.
Bless you. Some of the seeds for the night that we're enjoying tonight were probably sown several months ago as we contemplated a beautiful new album tribute to our sister Dottie Rambo. And I like to call that album Paul Crouch's favorites of all of Dottie Rambo's songs, sung by Vern Jackson. And, of course, how do you beat Tears Will Never Stain the Streets of That City? Or how do you beat I've Come Too Far? Are we too much to gain to lose? And just on and on and on, the beautiful songs that have blessed us. I think old Vern does them about as smooth as anybody, don't you? Why don't we give him a big old Nashville welcome tonight as Vern Jackson comes also to pay tribute to our sister, Dottie Rambo.
The splendor of heaven, knowing his destiny. was the lonely hill of Golgotha, there to lay down his life for me. If that isn't love, the ocean is dry. His side, he spoke with love and compassion. Then he took him to paradise. If that isn't love, the ocean is dry.
You know, Dottie, about 3 months ago, we finally got back to Nashville to try to finish this album up, and we did, and I'm really excited about it, and I want to thank you for all these wonderful, wonderful songs. You know, whenever I do an album, I usually have one or maybe two songs that are outstanding on that album, but, boy, there's 9 or 10 on this album that are totally outstanding, and I just love you. I love you. I like... Oh, thank you. Here's another one. For what earthly reason?
For what earthly reason would the Father send down his Son to suffer rejection and pay for crimes he had not done? For what earthly reason would he let him hang on a tree? I wept with the answer that one earthly reason was me.
summoned from the throne in the sky to purchase my pardon. Not even the angels could die. The only provision for my freedom was destined to be that sweet Lamb of glory, and his only reason was me. I was the reason that one earthly reason. I was the guilty. He was the sacrifice. I was the taker. He was the giver. Dying while I was me. That one earthly reason, that one earthly reason, that one earthly reason, that one earthly reason was me.
Vern Jackson. Thank you, Vern. By the way, that great album will be available the month of April during our great week of Praise-a-thon coming up very soon. And I think my little sweetheart did a pretty good job producing that record album. Don't you all think so? Yeah. Dottie, a lot of your friends couldn't be here tonight. It's kind of a blessing. I don't know where we'd put them all. This place is running over, and I saw cars having to leave. But, of course, one of the great things when you have a TV network is they can all run home and flip on the TV, and they're right here with us anyway. So one of those persons that would like to have been here tonight is living in Washington, D.C. also. And it reads as follows. From the House of Representatives to Dottie Rambo, congratulations on receiving the Christian Music, Country Music Association's Songwriter of the Century Award. Century Award. Boy, that kind of makes you feel old, doesn't it? Yeah. Christian music has always held a special place in my life. You have a true gift of song, and it is fitting that we pay tribute to your contributions, not only to gospel music, but to country music as well. Please feel free to contact me if I can ever be of assistance to you. My prayers are with you tonight as you receive this special honor. Sincerely, Bob Clement, 5th District, Tennessee, member of the House of Representatives.
I really do appreciate these, and I know Paul and Jan has a lot to do with some of the things that's going on here tonight, needless to tell you all that. But I'm overwhelmed. I've enjoyed all these songs I've written. I'm going to sit down and shut up and listen to them. Thank you.
We told you we were going to sing to you tonight. Another one of your dear friends that wishes he could be here tonight but could not be here tonight is Pat Boone. And I think we have a little recorded message from Pat tonight.
Hello, Miss Dottie. I sure do wish Shirley and I could be with you in person tonight, but we can't. We have to be back in earthquake country. So I really wish I could be with you tonight. I know you're having a wonderful time. Have you been through a box of Kleenex yet? Well, I bet you will before the night's over, because I know how it touches your heart for people to express their love and their appreciation for you, and that's exactly what I want to do right now. You know that I've recorded songs like I Go to the Rock and reaching around the world. I did that with the Onward Christian Soldiers, and it seemed to work really well. You write songs with such dynamic and such power, and you remind me, I was thinking today about this opportunity I would have, of somebody in the Bible, and I wonder if anybody's already beat me to this. Maybe not. I put these on just in honor of our peerage, so that I can peer at this Bible, actually, and see what I'm looking at. But I was reading this just the other day, and I thought of you. The 15th chapter of the book of Exodus, Moses had just led the children through on dry land, the children of Israel. And you know that Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. It's quite a long song. And then when it says, when Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and horsemen went into the sea, the Lord brought the waters of the sea back over them, but the Israelites walked through the sea on dry ground. Then Miriam, the prophetess, Aaron's sister, the part you should have played in the movie, The Ten Commandments, took a tambourine in her hand, and all the women followed her with tambourines and dancing, and Miriam sang to them, and I can hear your voice, sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted, the horse and its rider he has hurled into the sea. And boy, that seems to be a picture of you when the body of Christ, the people of God, have needed a song to express their elation, to express their need, to express their love for God, their concern for each other. You've always been there with just the right song. So you are a Miriam, you are a prophetess. And I think you realize that, the gift of God is on you and in you, and you've shared it so freely with all of us. And it's about time that we had a Dottie Rambo night. God bless you.
Thank you, Pat. Pat Boone. Well, Dottie, another one of your friends who is here tonight certainly needs no introduction in Nashville, Tennessee. One of your hometown gals is here tonight to bless us together. Her name is Connie Smith. Give her a hometown welcome.
I love you, Dottie. If I can continue the spirit that you put in this song. When I'm low in spirit, I cry, Lord, lift me up. I want to go higher with thee. But nothing grows high on a mountain. So he picked out a valley for me. Then he leads me beside still waters. Well, it's dark as a dungeon, and the sun seldom shines, and I question, Lord, why must this be? But he tells me there's strength in my sorrow. Oh, and there's victory in Christ. And he leads me beside still waters. Somewhere in the valley below. And he draws me aside to be tested and tried. And in the valley, he restores. Thank you.
is a good time being had by all tonight here in Nashville, Tennessee. In case our dear friends have just tuned in from across the nation, this is Praise the Lord, coming to you from Nashville as we honor our very special little sweetheart, Dottie Rambo. Another one of your friends that is here tonight, Dottie, and that is going to sing to you is Marty Raybon of Shenandoah. Give him a big old Nashville, we love you.
The things that I have and hold dear to my heart, they're just borrowed, they're not mine at all. Jesus only let me use them to brighten my life, so remind me, dear Lord. Roll back the curtain of memory now and then. Show me where you brought me from, oh, and where I could have been. I'm only human, and you know it's human. So remind me, dear Lord. Nothing good have I done to deserve God's own Son. The scars in his hand. Yet he chose the road to Calvary to die in my stead. Why he loved me, I can't understand. Roll back the curtains of me.
Marty Raybon, Shenandoah. Nashville, Tennessee, population 785,000. Salute. Junior and Grandpa, and I wish they could all be here tonight, but one of them is, and she knows, needs no introduction. Come on, Lulu Roman, give her a big old Nashville, we love you.
Sister, he gave me one with dark hair, and her name is Dottie, and she writes songs for me too. I love you.
I boast not of works or tell of good deeds, for naught have I done to merit his in my place. I will glory in the cross, let glory in the face.
You're a legend, you're going to have to learn how to act like a legend. But on the other hand, how do legends act? Most of them are already dead, and thank God you aren't among that number. But I want to tell you, it's been a real privilege to know you over the years, and thank God for the influence you've been on the Church of Jesus Christ at large, for the great ministry that you have put at our fingertips and in our mouths and in our hearts. It's been a real privilege knowing you over the years, and it hasn't been easy, but of course, being a legend never is. But on the other hand, being Dottie Rambo, I guess, is quite enough, and it's been a real privilege for me to know you. God bless you, and keep on keeping on. See you next.
Thank you, Ben Kenchlow, for those wonderful words from the 700 Club. Another hometown boy that's here to sing to you tonight, our little sweet Dottie Rambo, is Ricky Skaggs, his wife Sharon, and her sister Cheryl. Welcome, Ricky.
There's a voice now missing in our little country choir. Rock of ages will never sound the same. God heard her singing, and heaven was not.
Teaching angels out.
love you, Dottie. Praise the Lord for you. Well, what would the world have been like without Dottie Rambo? Without the wonderful harmony and the wonderful songs that's come through this woman from the Lord. And she'll be the first to tell you that she can't write a lick without him. And hey, none of us can. We can write and put down on paper, but if it ain't got the anointing, that's what breaks the yokes, is the anointing. She's got it. But it's so great to be here. When they asked me to do this, I said, yes, I would love nothing more than to come and get to be a little part of a wonderful tribute tonight to Dottie. We love her so much, and I want to introduce you to some folks that I love an awful lot, too. And I think these folks have probably been influenced as much or more than anybody here tonight by the Rambos because of Buck the father and Sharon and Cheryl, the two daughters, and how they have learned so many things from the Rambos. Please welcome the Whites, if you would.
Thank you. We're really honored to be a part of this tribute to you, Dottie. We love you so much. And I think every one of us can remember the first time we heard them sing. My daddy said he had to pull the car over to the side of the road. He had chill bumps so bad. And he came home and said, oh, girls, you got to hear what I heard on the radio today. And we became fans. We've always been influenced by the family harmonies. And the songs that God has blessed her with, we've recorded a few of them over the years and tried to do them justice. And I think her songs are real easy to do because of the messages in them. This one we've done in a little bit of a bluegrass style. We recorded it maybe a dozen years ago. And Ricky said, you didn't know you're a bluegrass writer, did you? Oh, she knew that. She knows her songs can be done anyway. But this is one of our favorites, and I hope you like the way we do it. It's called Follow the Leader.
Follow. Come on, let's follow the leader.
Yeah.
Are you standing at the crossroads, searching, wondering just which way to go? Are you chasing around in circles, tossed by every angry wind that blows? There's a plain and simple solution, Lord. Just lift your head and follow the sun. Don't look to the left or right. Keep your eyes upon the light. If you have respect, get to the other side.
Yeah,
look. Woo!
Lord, Lord. Grand Ole Opry, eat your heart out. Hey, hey, hey. How many remember a big old hit called Teddy Bear a few years ago? Well, one of your girlfriends is here tonight to sing to you also tonight, Dottie Rambo. Would you welcome Barbara Fairchild?
Too many miles behind me.
Child. Thank you, sweetheart. Lord, I hear that song and I say, that's my favorite. Then the next one comes and says, nope, that's my favorite. And then I say, no, they're all my favorite. Hey, I haven't heard a bad one yet. She's my favorite, yeah. Amen. I think we ought to give a very special thank you tonight to this beautiful couple that will join us now, because they have done the hard work behind the scenes of pulling all of this great evening together, the music, producers, and directors for this night's wonderful tribute to Dottie Rambo. Let's welcome Bill and Renee Morris and tell them thank you for this wonderful, wonderful evening.
There's a light in the window. The tables all spread in splendor. Someone standing by an open door. I can see a crystal river. I must be near forever. And I've never been this homesick before.
face is all familiar, but no one's old or feeble anymore. Oh, this lonesome heart keeps crying. I think I'll spread my wings for flying. Oh, I've never been this homesick before.
Bright lights shine. It's just around the corner.
And I can see my father's candy at the door.
It was in the early 60s, and my little home church, little Pentecostal church down in the southeast Texas town of Cleveland, I heard my first Dottie Rambo song. It said, "What can I give him for all he has given? What could I offer the Lord? I don't have riches, a castle, or a palace. What could I offer the Lord? When the earth is his footstool, and the heavens his throne, the cattle of 1,000 heels my Lord already owns. All that I have was his from the start. So all I can offer the Lord is my heart." Hallelujah. Wasn't long after that, my mother and daddy took me over to Moss Hill, Texas, a little white frame country church. The place was so packed that night. And for the very first time, we saw a little lady with a big voice and a big heart and a big guitar, and at that time, big hair. That's way back. Her music changed a whole generation of Christian music. It really did. It's been such an impact on our lives, and Dottie, it's an honor to be here tonight to say thanks God for the music that he gave through you. We love you. We're joined tonight with a very special friend, Candy Hemphill Christmas, and she's coming to sing for you at this time, Come Spring.
Could hardly speak. I brushed the tears.
There's a big gate standing open. A gentle voice calls me home. Soon I'll be in God's country, in a garden of my own, with my troubles far behind me, and my body.
Bill, Renee, we love you. Let's tell them one more time, thank you for all the hard work, planning, preparation, rehearsals that have made this evening already just one of the great highlights of the year for Trinity Broadcasting. How many have a little mama already on the other side along with me, beckoning us to come and see them? It won't be long, something in my spirit says. It won't be long till we'll see them. And it could be come spring. Praise God. Praise God. Well, friends, we have had a miracle tonight. Mike Perkey came and paid his pledge to me personally this evening. I think we ought to give old Mike Perkey a standing ovation as he comes to sing a very special song to Dottie Rambo. One of my favorites of all time, New Shoes!
Well, I heard the sound of angels coming across the distant hill. I hear them calling me away. Well, old friends now together outside my mansion door. I can feel the earth start to move away. So I made my reservation for my final destination. I'm changing to my mansion in the sky. Gonna wear some new clothes, like a shiny white robe. Walk around in new shoes. Get ready to move, ready to move. Yeah, come on. One more time! Well, I made my reservation for my final destination.
Now, Mike, I let you hang on to that $30, but you will bring it with you to the telethon, won't you?
I'm going to 40.
40? He's... Oh, my goodness.
Spoke to me. 40. Oh,
my goodness. Now, don't get in the flesh. Speaking of money, dear friends, as you leave tonight, you may drop your offering for our secret. Okay? Now, for you folks listening up and down the network, we have a secret. Can you all keep a secret? Yes. There's one honest guy back there that said no. But I mean, I have a secret, and I'm going to tell you about it tomorrow night on the program. And it is flat going to knock the devil's hat in the creek. And it has something to do with Nashville, and it has something to do with... Well, that's all I'm going to tell you. That's all I'm going to tell you. But we know, and we're going to keep it a secret, aren't we? And you're going to help me as you go out the door tonight, right? Don't shout me down. Yes, there will be offering buckets as you leave. And those at home, I'll tell you about it tomorrow night. And you're going to want to get excited about it as well, because it's going to mean, bottom line, a lot more wonderful nights just like we are enjoying tonight. Y'all having a good time here in Nashville, Tennessee, as we salute our sweet little angel, Dottie Rambo, on this great, historic Praise the Lord program. Remember, this is Praise the Lord. Prayer partners are on the line to talk with you, love you, pray with you, lead you to Jesus if you need to know Him tonight. Music is a sermon in a song, you know, and many people will be saved this evening as the anointing flows through so many of these wonderful friends who are singing the songs of Dottie Rambo tonight. Well, the next lady is well remembered for a song that we will not sing here tonight. How many remember Harper Valley PTA? Well, she's going to sing a little sweeter song than that tonight, but she's here tonight, and we love her very much. Jeannie C. Riley, one of your hometown gals. Come on, Jeannie.
I love you, Miss Dottie. I want to tell you, as they do the intro over and over, that you are so special, as you well know. Everybody here tonight knows that God is a friend to man, friend to us all. There sits a friend to God. This woman has let God hold her hand as the pen of God to write the greatest gospel catalog known to man. And God's word does not return to him void, but it accomplishes that it's sent out to do. Miss Dottie Rambo has had the wherewithal to open up the book, The Love Letters of God, and to read from him. But how many of us take the pen up and write love letters back to him? That's the word going out a second way. And then when we reopen the word after sending that word out to him, he brings it back to us again with healing in its wings. Healing is yours. Every word of every song going out tonight over the air, Miss Dottie, is God returning to you. Thank you for your love letters. Most of all, thank God for His.
I was going through memories and treasures today. Found you. With each stroke of your pen, I opened the letters and read them again. Then I counted the gifts you had given so free. You never stopped giving with no word from me. There were red and silk ribbons and words marked in red. I turned
remember I love you with a love I have loved you. I'd like to flame you, to name you my own. Remember with the love I have loved you. When you doubt that I do, count the tears scattered through my love letters to you. By the light of the candle, I picked up my pen. Words don't come easy, how do I begin? Oh, I pray I've not waited too long to reply. Angel, bear my letter to my love in the sky. I just read your answer with tears in my eyes. And you tell me that the stage has been set for the groom and the bride. Oh, but I shudder to think just how sad my life would be if I'd never read your love letters to me. Remember, I love you with the love I have loved you.
Jeannie C. Riley, thank you, sweetheart. Lord, I thought I knew all your songs, Dottie, but I'm hearing some new ones. I guess with 2,200, I couldn't have heard them all, or at least remembered them all. A little while ago, as one of them was being sung, she said, I plumb forgot I wrote that one. I guess that's possible with, that many. When you think of Dottie Rambo's songs and music, you don't really kind of put it together with a style of music we call contemporary, but a lot of the young people have grown up with and on Dottie Rambo's music, and there are a group of them here tonight, Dottie, to bless you and honor you and to sing some of your songs to you. The first to join us tonight is one of your little friends called Cindy Morgan. Would you welcome her as we continue to pay tribute to Dottie Rambo?
Good evening. I just wanted to say that this is such a special night for me to be able to stand on the same stage with such an incredible person as Dottie Rambo. And this song is really special to me because it's the very first song that I ever sang anywhere.
Thank you.
Mylon LeFevre.
Beyond all human understanding. us on the bus in 1969. Successful walking through the valley. You'll give me strength to climb the highest hill. The more I try, the better he can mold me. He will change.
Welcome, Janet Paschal.
The bright morning.
Janet Paschal. Thank you, sweet angel. And all of our wonderful musicians who are making this one of the most memorable nights that we've had in the now almost 21-year history of Trinity Broadcasting. You know, Dottie, when we're on a regular Praise the Lord program, I always try to coax out of you the little story behind each one of these songs. I wish we had time to do that tonight, because there's usually a little drama behind these songs. A valley, maybe a mountaintop, some sorrow, some joy, some gladness. You know what? It just hit me all of a sudden when we turned this little angel room into the Dottie Rambo set. We're really trying to coax her into doing a regular program. What we all think about that? Do you think that'd be a good idea? You'd have enough time then to kind of tell us some of those stories and how the Lord visited you in the angel room and dropped some of these wonderful songs into your heart that are blessing us tonight and have blessed us through the years.
You were kind of, I saw awestricken almost at lyrics that you weren't catching on the little song about Tiny. Had you not heard that before?
Never heard it.
A little girl had leukemia. She was 5 years old. Since she was three, she'd been following me around with her parents, and her hair began to come out. So Mama started making her long dresses, like Aunt Dottie, she called me. And as her hair came out, they made her little bonnets to go with it. She was getting weaker and weaker. And in my home in Nashville at that time was a two-story house. And in the middle of the night, the Lord woke me up, and I smelled flowers in my room. I knew it was God. I didn't know what was happening. But I tiptoed down the stairwell, got down in this little guest bedroom, and my little antique bedspread had roses and angels all over it. And I saw this little girl. Her name was Jennifer, but I named her Tiny. And she was saying, "Mama, why are you crying? And who's planting all these flowers on my bed? Daddy, why all the gloom?" And then the punchline God gave me, "And who's this nice man with scars in his hands? And he's leading Tiny out of a room." I thought I might really tell that one. I went to my bus, and she talked with me a little while, and she could hardly sit up, break time. So I went out to change my clothes, and I said, "Baby, how have you been?" She said, "I just heard a lot, Aunt Dottie." She said, "I'm going to get a lot of leukemia, a lot of cobalt, and yes, chemotherapy." And she said, "I get tired of doing that." And she propped her little elbow on my table, and she looked like this, and she said, "Do you know what I really want?" I said, "No, I don't, darling." She said, "I just want to go home to be with Jesus."
Oh, God.
So her mother said to me, I told her I'd written this for her, was going to put it on a record. She said, "Would you please just sing it with the guitar tonight?" I said, "But she's going to sit there and listen. Won't she get upset?" She said, no. "We want this on record." I sat there, and between the lines, I talked about the song. And when we got through, there wasn't a dry eye in the building except Tiny. And she was sitting up laughing and smiling, trying to clap her little hands. She's up there tonight, and I appreciate all the songs. There is a story behind all of them.
Oh, Lord.
And in time, we'll hear more of them, I hope. Dottie Rambo, how we love her. This young man, a few years ago, I suspect if you had told him that some night he would be singing a Dottie Rambo song in Music Village in Nashville, Tennessee, he probably would not have believed you. He is sort of Mr. Contemporary Music, too, if you please. As he was playing on Broadway, one of the most famous Broadway musicals ever in the great city of New York, Jesus Christ Superstar. But believe it or not, Jeff Finholt is here tonight, and he's going to sing a song to Dottie Rambo.
I love you. Praise God. This song is good for me. Praise the Lord. Praise you, Jesus.
Amazing grace shall always be my song of praise, for it was grace that bought my liberty. do not know why my Jesus loves me so. He looked beyond my faults and saw my need. I shall forever lift mine eyes to Calvary to view the cross where Jesus died.
Glad that you're saved here tonight, you know? Amen.
I shall forever lift mine eyes to Calvary to view the cross where Jesus died for me.
Tell us a little bit about a project that you're working on even now, today.
We're in the process. In fact, we were with Christ Church Choir until after midnight last night. Landy Gardner and Joy, and they're doing we're doing an album with Jeff Finholt right now. And it's got some wonderful songs, some non-Jeff songs. I mean, he can rock down. But this is going to be some golden daybreak, Grandmas.
Jeff Finholt?
Yes, and it is absolutely incredible. And beautiful songs like that. It's going to be a very, very special project, and we're in the middle of doing it right now. Thanks, Ronnie Henson. Thanks, Jeff. You know, he starred in Broadway on Jesus Christ Superstar, but now he's singing for the star, Jesus, in that song.
Yeah. Hey, hey, hey. You know, I just got to ask this question, and if he's not here, of course, he's not here, but somebody put a little bug in my ear and said that George Jones is in the audience here tonight somewhere. Are you here, George? If you are, wave at me or whistle or holler or something. Maybe somebody gave me the wrong information. If he was, I just want to meet you. He's one of my favorites. He and Merle Haggard. As I've said so often, if a man that don't like a little country music, I don't trust him. No. Yeah, something wrong with him. All right. The Wild Harmonica Man is here tonight. Back to Nashville, Tennessee, and Terry McMillan.
One of the first times I was on was the body, wasn't it? I love you. He can't keep us down, can he? Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord, you know that?
to talk with you. I don't believe it ain't never been done like this before. Oh, yeah, yeah. You know, my God, it speaks every language in the world.
My buddy, you still healed?
I'm healed.
All right. I do understand a very special lady is in the audience tonight. Jesse Coulter, Waylon Jennings' wife, is here. Would you stand, sweetheart, wherever you are? We'd like to just say hello to you right down here in the front row. Let's tell Jesse Coulter welcome tonight. All right, fasten your spiritual seatbelt, dear friends. The Dottie Rambo Singers and Orchestra join us right now for one of the uppers and movers, as I call them. I go to the rock.
Yeah.
Oh, children, you did a good job tonight. Dottie Rambo Singers and Orchestra. Dottie, I think you've got the background for your new program coming up. Yahoo! Yeah. Now I know where all the smoke came from in this place. Well, this evening would have never been complete without Dottie's one and only. She got it honest, I can tell you that, as we say in the South. And when she teamed up with Donnie McGuire, well, let's just say some more music was born. Let's tell the dynamic duo, Donnie and Reba Rambo McGuire.
We love you.
Dottie Rambo for a mom is a trip. When I first started writing songs, you know how pathetic first songs are. And I finally got up my courage, took it into mama, you know, and I knew three chords on a guitar, but I was, you know, I thought I was Chet Atkins. Took it in, I said, mama, I've finally written my first song, played it for her. She said, and she was wonderful. I mean, she kind of got misty-eyed, you know, great mom. I sang it was pathetic, but she was sweet. And at the end of the song, she says, oh, honey, that's so
good. Can I share with you what I'm working on? I said, sure. I handed her the guitar and she started singing, If That Isn't Love. I said, God, I ain't never writing another song if I can't write like Mama. What a blessing, though, to have a mom that not only sung the word and wrote the word in songs, but lived the word in front of me, and I honor her. I love you. I love you. Of course, with Mother, nothing was sacred. She wrote on everything because she always got inspired at the strangest times. She wrote songs on paper bags, you know, the grocery sack. She wrote them on those little white things in the center of pantyhose. She loved those pieces of white cardboard, toilet paper, anything. Yeah, she wrote songs on anything, and anything could inspire a song. I remember once we were traveling, and it was those days when we had slick tires and this old broke-down car, and you didn't call ahead because Holiday Inn, you know, we couldn't afford Holiday Inn. We stayed in those little mom-pop motels. We was traveling in the South. Everything was booked. It was a holiday weekend, and it was about 4 in the morning. We were all weary and grumpy. You know how you get. And every little motel had a sign that said, full up, no vacancy. We kept seeing this. We're all grumbling, complaining more. And all of a sudden, Mother gets that look. She kind of comes down with a song like people come down with the flu. And she got out an old paper bag and started writing on it. And I'll never forget it. It went, I've got a brand new sign with bright red letters hanging on the door of my heart. The Lord moved in. Why, I've never felt better. My life has changed. I've made a new start. So I'll let the devil know he isn't wanted anymore when he comes to calling on me. Oh, how mad he's going to be when he begins to read, full up, no vacancy.
When Reba and I began to look at all the list of songs and knew that this one wanted to sing this one and this one wanted to sing that one, we began to look at some of the songs that maybe some of the folks aren't familiar with, some in the last decade. And probably one of the greatest blessings in my life is that I've got to share a few of those with you. So we pulled some of the newer moments and are going to just share them with you.
And you better clap like it.
Tell them we love them. And Dion, yes. I have a sneaking suspicion that Israel and Destiny will end up on Grand Dot's TV program someday. Yes, yes, I think we can count on that.
She tells everybody I look like my Grand Dot and I act like my Grand Dot.
And who can argue with that? Yes, Israel is your prophet. He is, yes. Well, we have alluded to this all evening, but now we shall see exactly what we've been talking about. This Songwriter of the Century Award that sounds so very ancient. Here to make a very special presentation, perhaps unique in all the history of country and gospel music, is Bill Traylor, who is president of Homeland, Cheyenne, and Canaan Records, along with Gene Higgins, president of the Christian Country Music Association. Would you give these gentlemen a fine praise the Lord welcome tonight?
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Dottie, I know that you remember the days of the Gospel Echoes. That may not mean a whole lot to a lot of the folks here tonight, but I know it means a lot to Dottie Rambo, because those were the beginning days of Dottie's writing and singing. And a very dear friend of hers, who meant a lot to many of us as we were growing up in gospel music, Mr. Bob Benson, who was president of the Benson Company many years ago, said a thing one time. He said, "It all begins with a song. Beginnings begin with a song." And Dottie, I guess you've been the creator of many beginnings because of your prolific songwriting. And Dottie has written hundreds of gospel songs that have meant so much to people across the world. And it's with a great deal of pleasure that I introduce Mr. Gene Higgins, president of CCMA, Christian Country Music Association, to make a presentation to Dottie.
Thank you. Praise the name of the Lord. We're standing on the holy ground tonight, aren't we? Hallelujah. Glory. Woo. Praise God. Dottie Rambo has touched everybody's lives, and mine in particular. I was 14 years of age the first time I ever heard you sing. You was 15. but you've been an inspiration to Gene Higgins. And Lori Jones, our secretary, one day at work, she said, "Gene, TBN's going to do a tribute to Dottie Rambo. How can we be a part of that?" And two nights later, the Lord woke me up at 2 o'clock in the morning. And I said, "God, what is it?" And he said, "Dottie Rambo." And you came to my heart and you came to my mind. Praise God. Hallelujah. And I stayed awake from 2 to 4 o'clock, and finally the Lord said, the songwriter of the century. But one day, Jesus Christ is going to put a beautiful crown upon your head, and it's going to be much better than since the word we're giving you tonight. But in behalf of the Christian Country Music Association, we'd like to present to you the Songwriter of the Century Award, to Dottie Rambo. Woo!
I accept this with a lot of warmness and gladness, and I'm humbled that you would even present this to me. Thank you so much. And I hope when I am gone, I hope that there is something left behind me that can say, "She did always have a song." Amen. Because singing and talking about Jesus has been my life. I live on it. It's been my medicine the last 9 back surgeries. He's walked with me in the dark hours. When you said that the other night about the Lord talking to you, I had to cry because you didn't know what was going on in my life about then. But thank you, Bill. God bless you, sweetheart.
Thank you.
Thank you. This is one of my favorite songs the Lord ever gave me. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In a corner of a table, on a spread of ivory lace, framed and kissed by pastel colors, dancing through the crystal vase, bright and red. Its colors
taking nothing but the sunshine and leaving fragrance in the room. Hands reach up without a reason, crushed and bruised, the pain is full, causing yet a sweeter fragrance as the rose just began to fade away. You see, careless hands had crushed it and scattered it. Now, lying empty, seems like no use to anyone. Tasting death, that little rose just scatters and blows away in the wind. But there's another story. Excuse me, I'm just ad-libbing now. Is that all right? This is really what I wanted to say. Dear Jesus, I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord. In a corner of a stable, on a spread of swaddling clothes, just a tiny bud, but destined to become the perfect rose. Angels hailed his entrance, wise men brought him gold, knowing a little of the suffering that would soon befall the rose. Didn't he do that? Didn't he do that? Yes, he did. Hallelujah. Tasting death, the rose of Sharon rose to bloom. Praise. Hallelujah.
glad you've been with us for Praise the Lord. If you'd like an audio cassette of Praise the Lord, please write, ask for program 0224-94. That's 0224-94. The tapes will be sent for your love gift to the Praise the Lord program. TBN has a worldwide ministry. We need your love gifts, large or small, to help keep the gospel of Jesus Christ going around the world. So write today, Praise the Lord, P.O. Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711. Or in Canada, write TBN, P.O. Box 24215, APO, Richmond, British Columbia, V7B, 1Y2. If you haven't asked Christ into your life, call a prayer partner now and pray to receive Jesus as Savior and Lord. Now, until next time, remember to praise the Lord.
This program has been brought to you through the prayers and contributions of our faithful partners throughout North America and the world.